Hope you all are doing well in this phase of lockdown. Today we'll be starting our phase 3 of direction sense. Okay, so hopefully you have watched first and second lecture and you understood the concept. Today we'll be going with some advanced problem. Okay, up till now I think your direction, like in which direction someone is walking, what is clockwise, anti-clockwise, what are angles, all these things might be clear. Okay, so if they are clear about shadow, about where the person is standing, in which direction is moving, these problems are not difficult. Okay, so hopefully you have watched both the lectures first, that is very important, then only watch this third part. Okay, let's start with the problems. Okay, sure. First question: a car travels 25 kilometers towards south. Okay, it turns left and travels 30 kilometers and turns right and travels 15 kilometers. Okay, the question is asked, how far is car from the garage or from starting point, okay, from starting point, and in which direction? And in which direction? Okay, so hopefully, see, if you are clear about the concept, you can start solving it yourself. No need to wait for my solution, you can check it afterwards. Okay, let's start solving. A car travels 25 kilometers towards south. Means what? The car is going towards south. The first and most important thing, again, we'll go by this direction. This will be south, north, east, and west. You can draw this as well for north. That will get you a better idea. Now, 25 kilometers towards south. So let us start with some initial point. Let this be 25 kilometers. Then it turns left. Now accordingly, this will be in this position, turning left will be to the this side. Okay, it turns left and travels 30 kilometers. Okay, now it will be 30 kilometers. Now what happens? It turns right. Now it is facing in this direction, so turning right will be towards south again and travels 15 kilometers. Okay, so this will be somewhat 15 kilometers. Now the car is over here. How far is car from the starting point? So this was our starting point, let us say A. And this is our ending point, let us say B. Now they are asking in which direction. So first of all, it might be very clear that it is in the southeast direction. See, the point is over here. So if I imagine that I am watching somewhere towards here, so direction is very clear. So that should be a first answer, southeast. Okay. Now they have asked the distance as well. Let us start with this. Okay. Let us try to join this thing. Now first thing which you can see over here is like, okay, this thing I have, this will be 90 degree, this will be 90 degree. So shall I calculate this and this again? But this distance bifurcation is not given properly. So what should you do? So what should be your approach? You should extend this. I know this is 15, so I can extend this. I can join this. So this is my additional construction. This will be 15 itself again, and this will be 30 somewhere. Clear about? Okay. Now again, if this is a right angle triangle, I can apply Pythagoras theorem. So let us start. This total distance will be 25 plus 15 is equal to 40 kilometers, and this I know is 30 kilometers. Now I have both distances, I have to find AB. So AB square is equal to 40 square plus 30 square. So this will be 1600 plus 900. So that will be 2500. Okay, so which square is this? This is square of 50. So AB is 50 kilometers. So your answer will be 50 kilometers toward southeast. So this will be answer. Again, go through the problem. See, very easy. Just you have to add something more. The problems which you have seen up till now, whatever was happening, that we are just going by our conventional mathematics method, no construction, no extra thing. Okay. So now you have to add something more. So you have to keep this in mind. Okay, so go through this problem, we will proceed for the next. Okay, let us start. Hope you are understanding. If you are getting some difficulties, you can ask me afterwards. Okay, but still, I hope you all have got the answer properly. Okay, let us move towards next problem. Okay, next question. A boy walks 12 kilometers towards east. He turns 90 degree clockwise. Okay, 90 degree clockwise and walks 20 kilometers. Then he turn right and walk 33 kilometers. Okay, 33 kilometer. How far is he from starting point? Okay, you can proceed with the solution. Don't wait for my solution. You can proceed with your own solution. Pause the video, take down the question, and start solving. See, we'll go through the question once again. A boy walks 12 kilometers. Okay, towards east. Then turns 90 degree clockwise and walks 20 kilometers. He turns right and walks 33 kilometers. How far is he from starting point? Okay, how far is he from start? Okay, so hope question is clear to you all. Let us start making. Okay, so first of all, again, we will go by our reference diagram, north, south, east, and west. This arrow for your reference. Okay, this is not mandatory. Okay, this is not mandatory. This is just for your reference purpose. Okay, chalo, let's start. A boy walks 12 kilometers towards east. So, initial point A, 12 kilometers, he has walked east. Then, what he does? 90 degree clockwise. See, 90 degree clockwise means he is going towards south, not towards north direction. Okay. So he walks how much? 20 kilometers. So 20 kilometers. He turned right. Now he is in this position. Okay. So he will not move towards this side. He will move towards his right side. That will be towards west. And he walks how much? 33 kilometers. Now they are asking how far is from the starting point. So what they are asking? They are asking about this thing. So I can say AB. So what is AB? We have been asked what is AB. Okay, so not difficult, not much difficult. What we have to do, we have to add up some construction. So only we are calling this as some advanced problem. So we will just try to construct something. So if this is 20, this will be obviously 90. So I have optimized this side. Now this is 12. So reducing 12 from 33, what will be this? 21 kilometers. So now it is 20 and 21. So now you have to just calculate. You have to calculate AB square is equal to 21 square plus 20 square, so it will be 441 plus 841. So now 841 is a square of 29. Okay. So AB is 29 kilometers. Okay. AB is 29 kilometers. So answer will be 29 kilometers. Okay. You can check it afterward. You can check afterwards how we have solved, but this is very relatively very easy problem. But why I am taking this? Because there are some construction parts which you need to know. Okay, you need to know some construction parts. So I am taking this problem. So hopefully you are getting it. Let's move to our next problem. Just have a look at this. Okay, so hopefully you have got it. Next question. 9 cars A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and I are parked such that. So this problem is of relative dispositioning. Okay, relative positioning means with respect to me, where someone is standing. Okay, in this way. So first of all, what they have given? C is 4 kilometer east of B. Second, A is 2 km north of B. Okay, I am just writing initials. The question is big enough. H is 4 km west of H. Okay, sorry. G is 4 km west. Now, D is 6 km east of G. Then, fifth one. Okay, C is D, F. Okay, F is 4 km east of G. This will be B, B, A, H, G. Okay, then again H is 4 km south of A. And finally, there will be one. I is part in middle of B and C, and E is part in middle of H and D. Okay, so one question they have asked in this problem, lengthy problem. They have asked only single question, but we will have some multiple questions in this. Okay, so we will just try to draw what figure we are getting, and then accordingly we try to find out which different answers we can get. Okay, so let us read the question once again. Okay, let us start. 9 cards A, B, C, D, E, F, G up to I, they are given. Now 9 cards are parked relatively to each other, okay, with respect to each other. So you have to start from initial point. Let us start. C is 4 km of B. First of all, east of B, okay, towards east of B. B, if it is here, then C is 4 km over here. Okay, east of B. A is 2 km north of B. North, okay. So this will be 2 km north. What is this? A. Again, now we will find something which is relative to A. So, okay, we are getting something relative to A. H is 4 km south of A. Okay, so approach to the question should be in this way. You should find proper relativity. Okay, first of all, they can give the question in sequence, or they can just shuffle it for your confusion or wasting your time. So now, after this, I can draw this, but it is better I go with A reference. So H is 4 km towards south of A. Now, if H is towards this, so this should be 2 km because this is 2. I cannot draw 4 from here. This is 4 from A. So this should be 2. Okay, in diagram only we are going to clear a lot of problems. Okay. Now G is to the, now we will go with H as reference point. G is 4 km west. Now 4 km west, see in this, if you need, you should draw this thing. You should draw this thing because this will help you a lot. Now G is 4 km to west of H. Now I can draw H over here, and 4 km. What is this? G. Now with reference to G, D is 6 km east of G. 6 km. Now so I should be drawing here 2 km only. 2 km over here. Because what is happening? This is 4 and this 2. So G and D distance will be 6 itself. Now F is 4 km east of G. Okay. 4 km east of G. So again this will be something. See, D is 6 km east of D is east of G. Okay, so the solution is F is 4 km to east of G. Okay, now this is something confusing. Wait, can you see the question again? There might be some mistake that F is north of G. Okay, so this is north. So, north. It should be north. Okay, so now F is 4 km towards north of G. So 4 km I will draw in this way again. F, because this is 2, total is 4. So again I have drawn 4. Now A, this point we have covered. So mostly the diagram is done. Mostly the diagram is done. I is parked in middle of B and C. So I should be somewhere over here. And E is parked in middle of H and D. So E should be somewhere over here. Now they have given the question that what is the distance between H and D. Okay, they have given just a single question. What is distance between H and B. In this way they are given. So it will be obviously 2 kilometers. It will be obviously 2 kilometers. But this is relatively very simple. Relatively very simple question are. There can be multiple questions are asked on this question. Okay. There can be multiple questions asked on this. Okay. See, sequence was mostly given. Just one sentence was shuffled so that you should get somewhere confused. And after this, they have just asked, okay, what is distance between this? We know distance that is 2 kilometers. Because accordingly, we have solved when we are drawing. If not, you might calculate from this thing. See, D is 6 kilometers from east of G. So, G is 4 kilometers here and D should be 6, means 4 plus 2. And H was somewhere in between them. So, now that will be 2 kilometers. Okay. Now, what else questions can be asked? They can ask this, what is distance between F and A? They can ask this thing, what is distance between F and A? So that will be 4 kilometers. What is distance between C and D? Or in this way, or I and E. In this way, they can ask any questions. You can get different diagram, square, rectangle, or you can get a triangle and you can calculate easily. Okay, so this kind of questions are also asked. See, the question is lengthy. If you can read it properly, you can draw it faster and you can save your time. Okay, let's move towards next questions. Okay, let us see some more problems. Okay, sure. Facing towards south, Mr. X turns in certain way. This question is a bit different. Which of the turns will not lead him to same side? Okay, so options are given to the right, left, left, right, left, left, right, B, left, 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 right, right, and right, C, left, right, left, right, left, right. Okay. And D, right, left, right, left, right, and left. And E, none of the above. Okay. See, this is a different kind of question. Whatever you have seen up till now, it is related to direction sense, but you need not draw any diagram for this thing. Okay, so facing towards south, Mr. X turns in certain way. Which of the following turns will not lead him to the same side? Will not lead, okay? Okay, so imagine this way. If you, I am facing you people, okay? I am facing you people. If I turn towards my left in this way and again towards my right, this will lead to what? I will be facing the same side again. So they want a combination from this all, which will not lead to this. Means what? If I start from this position, I shouldn't return to this position. In this way, you should match the turn. So we'll go for the options one by one. Okay. See, now let us take some reference out of pen. These options can be shuffled. These options can be shuffled. You have to watch properly. So we will try to cancel each left with the right. If all those cancels properly, then he is going to lead to the same position. If not, he will not be to the same position, which is our desired answer. So this left goes with this right. This left goes with this, sorry, this right. Now this left and left are remaining. So definitely the first try has given our answer. This will be our answer. Because see, now left and right again same. Left and right again same, but left and left. So you will be not facing to the same direction again. Okay, you will not be facing. Let us analyze other options as well. This left with this one, this left with this one, this left with this one. So he will be to the same position again. Now this left to this right, this left to this right, this left to this right. So this will be again for the same position. So no, this also is not answer. This is definitely not answer because you have got one. this right to this left, this right to this left, this right to this left. So in this problem what we are seeing, the first option obviously is correct because there are two lefts. So whenever if he comes to the left, he will again move towards left. So he's not facing the same direction, he's facing the opposite direction. So this is the answer. So this was one different kind of question which I found it very interesting. We can get this kind of questions in your paper. Okay, need not be always drawing a diagram, finding some direction with Pythagoras, or we try properties of square and properties of rectangle. It can be a very simple question but logical, so you have to think over it. Okay, let's go for the next question. Okay, for next question, this will be on your screen. The next question will come on your screen. Okay, you have to just go through it. You have to note down the question because it's very lengthy. I'll be reading it and we'll be solving it simultaneously. So this is our question. Monica starts walking from point P. After walking 4 km in east direction, she reached to point Q. Then she turned to her left and walked 3 km to reach point R. From there, she turned back to P via shortest route. Okay, from there she starts walking in south direction, and after walking 5 km she reached to point S. Then she turned left and walked 8 km to reach point T. From there she turns left and walks equal distance of distance from point P to point S and reach point U. Finally she turned right and reaches to point V after walking 4 km. What will be the shortest distance of point P to point R? Option number A, 5 km, B, 14 km, C, 8 km, D, 6 km, and E, 9 km. Okay, let's start. So hopefully you have noted down your question. Pause the video, note down the question, and we'll start with the solution. So the question is, Monica starts walking from point P. Okay, so let us take a point P. Okay, and after walking 4 km in east, so let us draw our basic diagram of what we know: east, west, south, and north. So from P, after walking 4 km in east direction, so 4 km in east direction. Okay, now she reached point Q. She reached point Q. Okay, so you have to read your questions simultaneously, or you are not going to get anything. Pause the video, write down the question which was on your screen. Now, then she turned left and walked 3 km. So left from here means she is going in this direction, and she has reached some point R. And now this is interesting. From there, she turned to P. Okay, from this point, she turned back to P via shortest route. Okay, via shortest route. So definitely she has turned in this way. Okay, she has turned in this way. Now again she is at point P. Okay, again she is at point P. She starts walking in south direction for 5 km. So again from this she has walked 5 km. So somewhere she has reached for point S. She reached at point S. Then she turned left and walked 8 km. So left 8 km to reach point T. From there she turns left and walks equal distance of from point P to S. Okay, so equal distance from point P to S means she is walking in this direction for 5 km obviously. And now where she has reached? U. Okay, she has reached some point U. And finally she turns right and reaches to point V after walking for 4 km. Okay, so point V, what will be the shortest distance of point P to R? Okay, so P, R, upper distance P, R, whichever will lie. Okay, see the question was lengthy. Hopefully you have written the question and you have got what I have drawn over here. So first of all, from P to Q she walked 4 km, then she took left and walked 3 km, and from R point she took the shortest route to P. Okay, so the shortest route will be obviously from the hypotenuse. And now from P again 5 km she walks south, then from there she took left turn 8 km toward T, again left turn towards 5 km towards U, and then finally walking towards east 4 km, means taking right turn. Now they have asked here, okay, look at the question. we are wrong on this thing, but the question is limited to this factor only. Okay, so if you get this thing, if you read the question properly, what distance they are asking you, need not to draw this all. Okay, so that is your logic. But just I have drawn this to understand the question better. So 4 and 3, obviously, let us start. This is very easy for you people. 16, 9, 25 PR will be 5 kilometers. So whatever answer you are asking, PR will be 5 kilometers. This was the answer which they were asking. So this is relatively easy. More questions can be made on this, more questions. As like I can just ask this point QU. If I ask what is the distance between this point. Okay, this is an additional question which we can take. So I know up to this point it is 4. So remaining will be 4. So I can say QU is 4 kilometers again. Now I can ask what is the distance from P to V, from the starting point to the ending point. If the question is twisted, someone walks from home towards his office, what will be the distance between that? So taking all these terms, direct distance I can calculate from this. Okay, so what will be 4, 4, and 4? So that will be 12 kilometers. So 12 kilometers is the office. Again, if I want to ask something, I can ask this PT, I can ask this thing, P to T distance, I know this 4, this 8, so by the way, again, 8, 64, 25, again I will add my answer. So, in this way, you can get your answers easily. So, one question can create many questions. Okay, so try to imagine or analyze questions yourself. Whenever a diagram is completed, try to imagine what more questions can be generated and how can I solve it. So VT can be also a distance. You know this too. You can go by Pythagoras theorem again. See, this distance can be R. What is the shortest distance between V and T? And sometimes the questions are asked like from the starting point, traveling from every point, what is the total distance covered? See, what I'm asking, from starting points, traveling through by the road or whatever, what is the total distance covered? So I should start with 4 plus 3, then this 5 plus 5, okay? See, again understand this, total distance I'm asking up to V, so what will be the total distance? 4 plus 3 plus this 5 plus this 5, now plus 8, again this will be this 5 and finally 4. So this will be your total distance from P to V. This will be your total distance from P to V. You can calculate. So many questions can be asked on this, many questions can be easily asked on this. Okay, so let us move on towards next question. Okay, this question will be also on your screen. Please look at the screen, pause the video and write down the question in your notebook, and then we will start with the solution similar to this, because the question is very lengthy. It will take time to write it down. So better it is you write it down in your book and we will go with the solutions directly. Let's start. Narendra starts walking from his office towards his home. He starts from his office and walks 5 km. Then he turns left and walks 2 km. Then he turns left again and walks 4 km. Then he turns to his right and walks 3 km. Then he turns left and walks 1 km. And again he turns to his left and walks 4 km. Then turns to his right and walks 10 km. And finally turns right and walks 3 kilometers and reaches his house. If Narendra's house is facing south, in which direction did he start walking? First A, second option, first option is east, second option west, third option south, fourth north, and none of this. Okay, let's start.
Hopefully you have written the question in your book. Let us start. What is the question? Narendra starts walking from his office towards his home. Okay, he starts from his office and walks 5 kilometers. Okay, in this question, the one thing which is very confusing is that they have not given any initial direction. In which direction is he walking? There is nothing given in this, that in which direction is he exactly walking. So, in this sort of question, you have to start by yourself. You can take it north, you can take it south, you can take east, or you can take west. You have to choose one direction, you have to start. Okay, better choose north. Okay, better choose north. I always choose north for this type of questions. He starts and walks 5 kilometers. Okay, 5 kilometers he will walk. He turns left and walks 2 kilometers. So he has turned left 2 kilometers. Then, okay, we'll just try to make this more realistic. So this was our initial point. This is our initial point. Now, he turns left and walks 2 kilometers. Then he turns left and walks 4 kilometers. So definitely he is going towards this 4 kilometers. Right and walks 3 kilometers. So right will be this direction, 3 kilometers. He turns left and walks 1 kilometer. So downwards, south, 1 kilometer. Then again he turns to his left and walks 4 kilometers. So 4 kilometers from here. So this will be 4 kilometers from here. He is over here now. He is taking one more left and he is walking 1 kilometer. So again 1 kilometer over here. And then to his left and walks 4 kilometers. And 10 kilometers. Okay, so it is not 1, sorry, it is 10 kilometers. He is walking 10 kilometers. And then pilot takes a right and walks 3 kilometers. So takes a right and walks 3 kilometers. Now see, they have asked the question, if Narendra's house is facing south, so he has reached his home first of all. He has reached his home. So in which direction Narendra's house is facing south? So the house is facing south. Okay? And in which direction did he start walking? Did he start walking? Now see, now the first and most important thing, if the guy is entering from this side, definitely this might be door. So this is which direction? So this will be a south direction now. See what I told you, initially when you solve such kind of problems, when you don't know where the starting point exactly lies, you cannot rely on the coordinate system at all. You cannot rely on the coordinate system. You have to go by your instinct, by choosing one of the direction and then moving forward. Okay, so now one thing is very clear, this house is facing south, so he is entering from south direction. Now which direction did he start then? Which direction did he start? So now this coordinate system has changed. This is south. Okay, see from which part it will change. We'll just write it down so you will get a better idea. This was our standard system. Now according to this question, we have reached this direction. So this is south, this is north. Now east will be towards right. Okay, towards right. So left. So east will be here and west will be here. Okay, see in this type. Now once, see this is tilted in this way, you can see it is tilted in this way. Now you have got this new or modified coordinate system according to the question. This is not standard one, this is according to the question. Now one thing, which direction did he start? So we have chosen this direction initially. So definitely he was starting from east. He had started walking from east because we have chosen this direction to start. So according to this graph, we have started from east direction. Okay, and finally we have come to south. So see, these were some different type of questions which I was willing that you should solve this thing, or you can call them some advanced, because we have some construction part, we have some different questions like left and right turns. We have seen these are very neat questions, even this one, because what students do, they rely on the standard coordinate system, but it is not always, because the question can be anything asked. So this question is very very important, because such questions can be asked in your examination. So hopefully you have got my lecture for today. So this was our part 3 for direction sense. So direction sense is completed. So in upcoming lectures, we will be discussing some more and interesting points. But whatever studies given to you, people, you should complete it. Your notes should be complete. And whenever I ask, you have to produce them. Okay. So thank you. Let us meet.